Hello students, today's topic is picking motion. Picking is the next process after shedding in the sequence of primary motions. So we can say in the primary motion, this is the second motion. After shedding is the first, after shedding it is the second motion. It consists of passing of weft yarn through the shed of warp threads. We are dividing the warp threads into two layers, that is known as shed. And when the shed is open, we insert a weft thread with the help of weft insertion method. Whatever the weft insertion method we are using, if we are using shuttle looms, it is through the shuttle, or if we are using shuttleless looms, then it is depending on the loom. Now, what are the objects of picking? The main object of any conventional picking, conventional means shuttle looms. The main object of any conventional picking where we are using fly shuttles is used as a weft carrier are as follows. First, to deliver the shuttle along the correct flight path. Means the shuttle should be delivered on a correct flight path. And second is to project the shuttle on a predetermined velocity, means whatever the required velocity, on which what is the required velocity, on that velocity we are projecting the shuttle so that it can reach from one box to another box. How we achieve these objects of picking? For that, what is the required arrangement? The first is the shuttle box back and the reed are in perfect alignment. So because the reed is guiding the shuttle when it is traveling from one shuttle box to another shuttle box, so this reed and shuttle box back should be in perfect alignment. If it is not in perfect alignment, then shuttle fly may take place, shuttle may fly out. So to avoid that, these should remain in proper alignment. The shuttle box base and the race board means the base of sleigh race. So the shuttle box base and the base of the race board are in perfect alignment. So it will also avoid the chances of shuttle flying. The shuttle delivered satisfactorily by the picker. Otherwise, there may be chances of shuttle fly off or trap. If it is at a very higher velocity, shuttle flying may take place, or if it is at a very low velocity, then it will not reach to the another box and shuttle trapping will take place. So to avoid shuttle fly and shuttle trap, we have to consider these three arrangements properly or perfectly. Now, types of picking motion. We can categorize picking motion mainly into two categories: overpick motion, in which we are using cone, so it is also known as cone overpick motion, and another is underpick motion. Underpick motions are of two types: cone underpick motion and side lever underpick motion. Now we will take comparison between overpick looms and underpick looms. Underpick looms means on which we are using underpick mechanism, or overpick looms means on which we are using overpick mechanism for picking. So we can compare these two on the basis of few points. The first is position of picking arm. In case of underpick looms, it is just below the shuttle box. The position of the picking arm is just below the shuttle box, and because this is below means this is under, that's why this is known as underpick. The position of picking arm is under the shuttle box, that's why it is known as underpick. And as the name suggests, in overpick, the picking arm position is just above the shuttle box. It is above or it is over, that's why it is known as overpick mechanism. Then speed of loom, speed of underloom is lesser as compared to overpick. So the looms which are having underpick mechanism are running at lesser speed as compared to overpick, whereas overpick are having higher speeds. Size of loom, underpick mechanism is used on broad and medium looms, whereas overpick is used for narrow pick looms, narrow width looms like shirting. and this underpeak is like shooting or other purposes. Power consumption is more in underpeak looms as compared to overpeak. Fabric woven on loom used for weaving heavy fabrics and also used for silk and rayon fabrics. Underpeak mechanism is used for heavy fabrics, whereas overpeak is used for medium and lightweight fabric. Chances of oiling during maintenance, because here we are using no spindle we are using in underpeak, so there is no need of oiling, so chances of staining will be avoided. But in case of overpeak mechanism, we are using spindle on which the peaker travels to force the shuttle from one side to other side. So this spindle should be oiled regularly, and that's why there are chances of stains on the fabric is there, and that is taken as a defect. And noise production is more in case of underpeak as compared to overpeak looms. Now we will take one type of mechanism, that is side lever underpeak motion. Side lever underpeak motion, this is the simplest motion used for weaving all type of fabrics, and all the parts fitted outside of loom, so it is easy to maintenance. Now we will understand the working principle and construction of side lever underpeak motion with the help of diagram.